Hello friends and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. This tutorial will make you go through the introductory concepts of greedy algorithms. Before we begin, let's consider a situation. There is this very intelligent guy who knows programming. He is very rich and has an infinite supply of $20, $10 and $5 coins. Now, he has a friend who needs some money. He asks for $35 and that too in minimum number of coins. Now, if he was to just give money, he could have given it in quite a number of ways. He could give 7 coins of $5, a $10 coin and 5 $5 coin and so on. But since he is supposed to pay minimum number of coins, he has to come up with a greedy idea. After thinking for a while, he proposes a solution. For every iteration, he has to give a coin of largest value that does not take him past the amount to be given. Now for $35, the largest denomination he can start giving is $20. Now $15 are short to the amount. So the next largest he can give is $10. Now he needs $5 more. And since he have it as a denomination, one coin of $5 and the loan is given in just 3 coins. Here the thing to note is that after every iteration, he is making a choice. One which is greedy in nature, giving the coin with largest value possible. This method will however not work for all denomination and currencies. Now we will formulate the idea of greedy algorithms. Greedy algorithm follows problem-solving approach of making the locally optimal choice at each stage with the hope of finding a global optimum. So at each stage, we select a locally optimal value with the hope of getting to the best possible solution. This is a useful programming methodology. Let's see few of its pros and cons. So this approach is simple, easy to code and implement, and have reasonable running complexity. However, the main drawback for this method is that there are very few cases wherein we end up getting the globally optimal value. With this example, we'll see how the algorithm makes locally optimal choices, however, ending up at a non-optimal solution. So, in this tree, we are required to get the largest root to leaf sum. That is, starting from this root node here, we have to find a path ending at a leaf node and having sum of nodes as maximum. So let's start from our root node. The sum at start is 3. There are two possible paths, 4 and 7. However, here we make a greedy choice and choose the one that is maximum, that is 7. Our total now is 10. Now, once at 7, we have to choose between 9 and 11. A greedy choice would be to select the larger of the two. We select 11 and end up having a path with sum as 21. Can we do better than this? Yes, we have a path. If we start from 3, go to 4 and then to 20, this path would give us a sum of 27, which is greater than the one we have achieved through greedy method. So here we conclude that making locally optimal greedy choices don't always give us a globally optimal value. So when are we supposed to use greedy methods? All problems which are generally solved using greedy algorithm satisfy two properties. The greedy choice property, that is, making the best choice at a moment leading to a global optimum. Next property is the optimal substructure. Problems whose optimal solution can be constructed efficiently from optimal solution of its subproblems. This property may look similar to one in dynamic programming. However, one thing to note here is that greedy algorithm never reconsiders its choices. This is the main difference from dynamic programming, which is exhaustive and is guaranteed to find a solution. Finally, we look at some application which uses greedy algorithms. Activity selection problem, Huffman coding, job sequencing problem, fractional knapsack problem, Prim's minimum spanning tree are few of such applications. With this, we wrap up this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.